This episode is brought to you by Pacific Plate Brewing Company. This week on Humpcast, we get a big Venom trailer, MoviePass takes a dive, Joker movie wants Marc Maron, Spotify boots Alex Jones, and a speedboat holdup. You're listening to Humpcast.
Hit it already!
Ow! All right. I don't even know what one of these buttons doesn't work. I don't even know which one it is.
Fix the audio.
Yeah. All right. Welcome to Humpcast, everybody. The show where a couple of buds get buzzed and do a show a day late. But don't worry. We got you, mate. My name's Garrett Lee.
I'm Ryan D.
And today we are actually starting off.
We are Australian today.
Australian. So thank you for all of our Australian viewers and listeners.
It's very hot in here.
It is. We are still in Southern California where it's hot as fuck. But we have actually been powered by Pacific Plate Brewing Company.
Powered by.
Yeah, so we got a little bit of a beer sponsor, so I like that.
So Pacific Plate has been hooking us up with a few tall boys here of their collection.
And we got two right now. I'm going to start off with the, and I haven't had either of these.
Well, last time that they gave me a couple packs was, it was the Orchata Stout and I think the mango IPA.
Ooh.
So this time it's the guava IPA and Balanced Breakfast, which is a new one.
Yeah.
That they just started canning. So
this is a New England style India pale ale brewed with oatmeal raisin cookies. Whoa. Lactose and citra and amarillo hops.
And if I'm not mistaken, our friend Javi at the Full Pint.
Yeah.
Brewed and canned that too.
Nice. And this is coming in at a nice round 7%.
Yep.
I have never had this and I'm about to try it for the first time.
And also, Vicky, my fiance, is on the canning line and also now the events coordinator.
Nice. Thanks, Vicky. Nice cans.
So, here we go. I want to know what you think because you actually haven't had this one at all.
No, I haven't had any of these, really.
So, the guava might be my favorite.
I'm glad. I want to.
Well, the guava and the mango are both, they're tied for first.
Okay.
This one's a little full. It's
so I decided to start with this because it just seemed like it would have less. I mean, like more subtle notes as opposed to the guava. Guavas tend to be a little bit more pronounced in anything. This just said oatmeal cookies, and it actually said cookies, lactose and citra and amarillo hops. So it's like, I'm not sure exactly what to expect, and it's an IPA. So I'm going to give it a chance.
I want to hear what you think about this one.
Oh, wow. Okay, so it's like super smooth.
It's, in my opinion, it's just a...
Oh, there it is. Okay, and as a finish with that cookie.
Do you actually taste it?
I do. It tastes like there's, like, I just ate a cookie. But like very, very like not it's not like you actually had a cookie, but it was like literally a tiny amount of like the sugar and a little bit of the,
like, it's in there. I know it's in the brew, but
yeah.
I've never
sweet
gotten that hint of it. Like,
no,
never,
I definitely get it.
Like, to me it just tastes like a you know, full bodied IPA.
Which you definitely get a lot of that. So the hops don't overpower it, which I thought they might. I'm glad. You definitely get a pronounced aspect of both of those, but the oatmeal cookie, you just get that tiny hint. I thought you would actually have a little bit more, like too much, and that's what I was preparing for, but this is really nice. If you're a fan of something like milk stouts or anything with a little bit of the lactose in there, and of course, if you're cool with it, lactose, that is, definitely give this a try. This is interesting. I have never had an IPA that has this much of a sort of different sort of aspect, whereas most of them go for some sort of fruit or juicy or tropical.
Yeah.
This one has a raisin cookie, which is very interesting. Definitely sweeter, for sure.
Well, it's called Balanced Breakfast, and I'm not going to lie. I've definitely had it for breakfast.
That makes sense.
It's very filling and tasty.
And full disclosure, I've been drinking all day.
Yeah.
I just got back from hanging out with our friend Jeremy Northwood over in San Gabriel.
I had to find you.
Yeah, well, seriously, because I kind of passed out for a bit.
Not find you, but
he had to call me. He's like, "Hey, where are you? I'm at your house," because this is where we record the podcast. And I'm like, "What? You were supposed to let me know when you left. I was asleep."
But I did actually let you know.
He texted me, but that was it. Like, he just gave me a little text. He's like, "I'm on my way."
And I just kind of figured you were already here. I don't know why. Yeah. I don't know. You're usually more responsible. That's, you pulled a real Ryan D move today.
I did. I figured today was my day. I get to do one. Yeah. So that's why we're a little bit later than usual.
Everybody else gets one Ryan D day. I get them every day.
Good. Good job. Yeah. All right. Well, I got one. Yeah, we're here now. So that's really cool. I'm really happy that this is happening right now. And I'm excited because I haven't seen you in forever. And
it's only been like a week.
Forever. Forever.
We drank a lot last week, though.
Yeah, we did.
I wound up in a fucking haze. Was it last week? Fuck, why did it feel so fucking long ago?
Fucking, I don't know.
Tequila.
Yeah. It just takes longer tequila, for the weeks to go by.
Tequila makes you time travel.
It does. But it's fun. So that's cool. I'm cool with it. How have you been? Like, have you been doing any shows? You doing anything like that? Doing anything crazy?
Unfortunately, I've had to cancel a couple shows.
Oh, no. What happened, dude?
I just have this new job, and it's kind of fucking... I'm still kind of new. I'm still a temp, so I don't really want to ask for too much time off and too many days to leave early. Yeah. So, unfortunately, like, if I have to stay till 10... I usually have to stay till 10, like, on the weekdays, and that's usually when I get, like, my... you know, my regular spots and whatnot. So it's like, it's really hard to make it to spots on time unless I just happen to like get out early or whatever. So I just can't request too much because I'm a new employee. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So for the most part, like only Fridays and Saturdays, I've been doing a lot of stuff. But the big news is, like I said, my fiance is doing the events for Pacific Plate now at both locations.
Hell yeah.
So I'm doing Friday nights in Glendale once a month, comedy night, and then Saturday nights at Monrovia.
Nice.
There's a big one coming up on August 25th at the Monrovia location. It's going to be a big show. We're going to have caterers and everything. Or not caterers, but food people. Like a food truck or something is going to be there.
Good enough.
That's I'm not sure what kind of food yet, but...
Nice.
Yeah. So now they're letting her fucking just take the reins. She's just every weekend we're coming up with new ideas to like put on some fun things for people to do.
Nice. That's awesome, dude. I mean, that's always awesome. As long as you're doing something that you like, it's going through like your,
yeah. And they have
what you want to do.
And they have her doing sales too. So she's kind of going around and trying to get liquor stores and bars to get kegs and cans.
There you go.
So, it's like, and she gets commission on that. And it's like, dude, that's the job she wanted. So like, it only took a couple months for her to get it, and it was just, but she's getting being a little hard on herself. And I'm just like, dude, you're gonna be good at this job. I already know it. Like,
just work hard, dude. Yeah. Seriously.
Yeah, and I've been helping her out a lot too. So
nice, good to hear. Awesome. Yeah. I got out of a few meetings actually with one of the Proko guys, and I saw some good footage of the last two short films that I was in. That was pretty cool.
Okay, so there's two? I thought there was
one. Right now I have two short films in post-production with the Proko guys, and one's called Ancient Games. It definitely is very interesting. It is if you're a fan of D&D, you'll definitely understand it. And if you aren't, from what I saw, it looks like it explains it pretty well. It has a lot to do with... Did you spill on yourself?
I spilled on myself, but I think I just... No, yeah, I spilled on myself a little bit. Hold on, let me just...
Hold on, we got to get Ryan a bib. Hold on.
Let me chime in real quick and remind you guys that this is the Guava IPA from Pacific Plate. And it's delicious. And you can find it pretty much at any craft beer location that you go and buy your craft beer, like in LA.
Yeah, dude, seriously. Like, so I've been seeing their stuff all over, and I was surprised.
Like those big craft beer stores.
Yeah, like I went to Vendome, which is, if you're is from like the North Hollywood area, you know Vendome. It's a very big one. And then there's one also in Arcadia, and they have Pacific Plate. And I was like, that's pretty cool. I didn't know that
they're doing pretty good.
Yeah, so
with
that's
the
awesome.
With the can sales. But
because I remember we because we were local, we had them on for like really early on. And so I'm really happy to do that. Yeah. Now we have good ties with them.
Yeah, really early on. But the guy, it's so funny because that episode just came up on my like memories feed.
Oh, did it?
And it's just, and like that dude like cut ties with the brewery. The
yeah,
guy that
I know. But I mean, still, it's like we still have good ties with the brewery. And so that's cool.
Yeah, I know. It's just so funny how like that worked out, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I don't know.
But well, I mean, yeah.
Like, I kind of trip out on that, like, because we knew that guy, and I remember like us wanting to work with them a lot more with other stuff, and I think I remember him maybe kind of blaming it on the other guys or something like that, like saying that it's something that he's into, and they don't think that they you know the other dudes want to be into for, like, certain things or whatever. But I remember it being it was kind of a hard time.
It's all about the he said she said bullshit.
Yeah, but it's funny.
Shout out Limp Bizkit.
It's just funny. It's funny now that like I'm super involved with this brewery.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, like, if you're having fun with them and it's all cool, then
they're great. It
doesn't fucking really matter. But that's awesome. Yeah,
expect big things. They're actually they're planning on expanding too. So
good.
Yeah,
straight up.
Yeah,
that's awesome. Yeah. So, but that's what I've been doing. I've been waiting on those two things to come out of pre-production. They look really nice. I can't wait to share a trailer once it actually drops. And I have a meeting for another short film in August. So that's really cool. I'm excited for that.
Same
I can't talk about... No, different people. This time, completely different people. They've seen some stuff and they're like, yeah, I want to see if you want to work with us.
Did you get this? Like through Craigslist? Or
no, this was completely through word of mouth.
Really?
So, yeah, people seeing me in different shorts,
nice.
Internet stuff, and so I'm happy with that.
Wait, so somebody hit you up?
Or absolutely, yeah. Somebody hit me up
to do their short.
Exactly. It's a short, and then I think they said that they're trying to get it, if it's good, into a series.
Look at you, bro. That's a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, that's what, like, I always want to work hard, and I love this industry, so it's like, no matter what, I'm always going to be doing something because I want to. I don't feel happy when I'm just lounging about. Like,
for sure.
Literally, I need to be doing something. So, I mean, I can't say much about it yet, but when I can, I'm can't wait, to be honest.
You should still take pride that that's the first time somebody hit you up for a gig.
It's not the first time.
Oh.
But I am still proud of it.
Well, whatever.
Yeah, exactly. All right, guys. Anything coming up do you want to talk about real quick, or you want to just jump into stories real quick?
Silver Dollar show next Tuesday, August 7th.
Friendly reminder for all y'all, and locally at least.
Special guest, Ballast Point Brewing Company will be there.
There you go.
Giving out some merch.
The entire brewery will be there.
Well,
you heard it here, you guys. The entire Ballast Point will be
here.
Will be at the Silver Dollar Saloon.
All of the points.
All of them.
All the Ballast Points.
All of them, exactly.
No, so I guess a rep's going to be there. They're gonna have one. They're taking over one tap, and then
are they gonna be bringing anything new? Because in all honesty, every time I've had Ballast Point,
I don't know.
I see it, it's just the same old shit.
I don't think so. I think it's just the sculpin. But still, as far as I know, they're gonna be giving out a lot of beer.
Ooh, nice.
Giving out a lot of swag too. So
I like both those things.
So if you're in the area, come through. It's free. All right.
So what's the date? Tuesday. What?
Tuesday, next Tuesday, so August 7th.
August 7th, check it out.
9 o'clock.
Silver Dollar Saloon in El Monte, California. And let's jump into some stories.
I may have some news for you.
Go ahead.
Entertainment news, everybody.
This just broke out.
That is a scientific fact.
Huh? I'm not going to get to this story. I have a question for you.
News story that'll make you guys a little bit tingly in the pants.
Okay, we need to move on from that. I need to get away from that.
I read somewhere that their periods attract bears.
You are on the effects today.
Thank you.
Bitch, what the fuck?
All right, guys, let's jump into the weekend box office real quick. So one thing that I was planning on seeing, but I haven't actually, so I'll see it this weekend, is actually Mission Impossible Fallout. This is going to be the sixth installment of the franchise, and it's actually coming in with a $61.2 million budget, or million-dollar rake-in, just domestically. So good for them.
Best in franchise history, I heard.
I believe so, exactly. Sorry, I'm burping a lot. And this one's really
cool. That's crazy to me. What number is this? Like five?
Six. This is six. This is you got one, one, two, and three. Or no, I think it's one, two. Yeah, one, two, three, Rogue Nation, Ghost Protocol, Fallout. Boom.
I don't think I saw Ghost Protocol.
I didn't see three and Ghost Protocol. I saw Rogue Nation extremely fucked up, and I don't remember it. And
was that the one you saw in 40X?
Yeah. All I remember is getting punched in the fucking spine.
I remember seeing it. That's the one
and
where they...
That was too much, because I ate half an edible that Ricky gave me. and you freaked out?
And yeah, hated,
I was like,
and
you
hated 40X?
I should have only eaten one bite. And yeah. I'd already been drinking. Like, we had already been drinking.
That's the worst.
And then we're in there. I'm like, all right, this is cool. And I'm like, oh.
That's the worst.
And it's like fucking lightning and spinal punches. And I was like,
oh, my God.
I can't handle this.
That is
I can't handle this.
That is so crazy for being that high.
Yes. Oh, and so I can't imagine. I remember bits and pieces, but I don't remember the whole plot of it. So.
Imagine. All my senses get so heightened when I'm stoned like that. Can't fucking.
No, neither can I. I did the same thing with Ready Player One, except that was a tiny bit different. I had a soda, THC soda that I wasn't expecting to hit me as hard as it did, but it just punched me into a different fucking
galaxy dimension.
Yeah, exactly.
I went and hung out with our friend Tony Alfano.
Mm-hmm.
On Saturday. I was like, he kept hitting me up because he's not working, and he's like,
yeah.
He's back in his old area, but like just fucking doesn't have anything to do. So I was like, yeah, man, like I'll come over, I'll hang out, whatever. So he's been hitting me up to go check out his new place and hang out. So I finally went over there on Saturday, and he was like, we'll go swimming or whatever.
Yeah.
And he's always bugging me to like smoke with him because I don't really smoke pot.
Yeah.
And like, so I'm like, okay, fine. He's like, he wanted to show me his new 4K TV too. And the fact that he just got all the new Jurassic Parks on 4K.
Look at these fucking dinos, bro.
He's like, dude, you got to see how fucking those scenes with the dinosaurs is fucking crazy in 4K. So I was like, all right, yeah, cool. And then he was like, dude, smoke this. It's going to be much better. And so like I was like, okay, I'm going to take a baby hit.
Yeah, baby hit.
So I took a tiny little like bong rip.
Yeah.
And I was in another fucking dimension.
Well,
bro.
I think, okay, so you and I think, have very.
Oh, man, I was such a baby.
Very similar responses when it comes to actual, like smoking weed or yeah. even, like, ingesting any sort of THC. We are super sensitive, I think, to as opposed to a lot of people where, like, they can just do it all day. Ryan and I could take one hit or one bite of a fucking edible, and we're like, nope.
Dead. Fucking.
Nope.
Dead, bro.
And it's not.
He was like,
yeah.
He was like, I should have told you, it's like the strongest weed you can get on the market
in the world.
He's like, this is called Moon Rocks. You ever heard of that? And I was like, yeah.
It sends you to the moon.
So I literally like just the only thing that was moving on my body was my arm to eat pretzels.
Wow. Yeah.
And then he was like showing me different clips of different movies in 4K, and I was just like, whoa.
It's amazing. You don't want to move ever.
Yeah. Did not go swimming.
Yeah, dude. I mean,
I could not move.
I know you and I fucking can't do that. Shouldn't be active at all. Whereas some people are perfectly functional. We are not.
I don't understand it.
But and we know it at least.
Don't get it.
We don't know why. We just know that literally, like,
no,
Ryan and I can't do more than like a hit.
I don't understand.
And then be functional.
I don't understand how so many of my friends can do that shit all day long and be productive.
But on the flip side, we can have like 1,000 beers and be like, no, we're good.
That's true. Well, but by like the 900th.
Yeah.
I'm not good at what I'm doing.
No, I mean, we're not good at it, but we can still function. We could talk.
We can
like, I'm on my 7th or 8th beer today. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. All right. So, yeah, that was the top box office. I can't wait to see it. I've heard good things about it.
Wait, I don't even think you did 2 and 3, did you?
I'm talking about the first one still.
Oh, I thought you said that was top box office. Sorry.
No, that was the top. That was number one.
Sorry.
Yeah, and so if you have been following along.
Fuck you up, dude.
Thank you, dude. I appreciate
that.
I'm
just here to
keep me
fuck
on my toes.
You up.
I appreciate it. Yeah, definitely. If you have been following, check this out. If you haven't, go find it on Vudu or Amazon or whatever. It's not on Netflix. I looked on Netflix. It's not on there.
What?
All the other Mission Impossibles. What I heard is you don't necessarily need to have seen them. However, they do help a lot.
Yeah, they've gotten to a point to where they're like Bond movies where they kind of don't really matter.
What they usually do is they'll introduce a new character and then they're like they give exposition to this character so that you know.
Yeah,
and they're like, oh, okay, I know what's going on. But of course, it's not the same as seeing all the prior movies and understanding.
I bet
the
it
legacy.
Didn't have a, I bet it didn't have a sick ass fucking. Soundtrack, bro. MI2. Like did MI2 did.
Did that have a sick soundtrack?
It was a big deal. You don't remember?
I don't remember
it was like
at all.
Static X, fucking Power Man 5000.
Dang.
Metallica.
I heard
Limp Bizkit. You don't remember that Limp Bizkit cover?
I do, actually. I heard that they brought all those people back for this soundtrack.
Dope.
For,
Seven Dust,
so,
dude.
Boom. There you go. Boom. Number two. Mamma Mia. Here we go again.
That was number two?
Yeah, dude. In its second week. Mamma Mia overtook The Equalizer. It overtook Hotel Transylvania. And its first week, which is actually, funnily enough, the only movie I saw this weekend, Teen Titans Go to the movies.
Oh, my God. Did you like it?
I thought it was okay. I'm a fan of the franchise, but I'm not a fan of the...
I'm not a fan.
Yeah, this one. I love Teen Titans, and I love a lot of DC stuff. But the Teen Titans Go, once they change the format, is a little bit too dumbed down for me.
Yeah,
and I understand the appeal. It's much more whimsical. It's much more fucking fantastic and kid-oriented, I guess. But the movie wasn't bad, in all honesty.
Seemed like it would be a funny movie.
It is. It's funny. It's just you got to kind of just go in. It kind of reminded me a lot of like a Lego Batman movie.
I've caught a few episodes of the Teen Titans Go. It's pretty funny.
Yeah, exactly. But if you're comparing it to Teen Titans... Excuse me.
Yeah, it's not even close.
Yeah, it's very different. Teen Titans is very much like a Young Justice, or I like to equate it to like something like Avatar, where it's a cartoon, but it very much is. It doesn't treat you like an idiot.
Whereas Teen Titans Go does.
Yeah. In my opinion. I'm not saying anything bad about it, but, you know, it's very different.
But you saw it
different.
And enjoyed it.
I did. I was like, this is cool. And then I was like, oh, cool. And then I will say this. If you saw it, you know, at the very end, there's something that got me pretty excited and should get a lot of Teen Titans fans excited as well.
Well, they kind of make fun of the actual DC cinematic universe
a
little bit.
It's very self-referential, and that's why I was saying it's a lot like Batman, Lego Batman.
Yeah.
It was self-referential. It definitely took a lot of the funnier things that like it took flack for, and it used them. It just embraced them. One of the lines was because the superheroes, they're the sidekicks, were all like, oh, you guys all have movies. And it was like Superman, Wonder Woman, and Green Lantern. And Superman's like, yup. And Wonder Woman's like, yeah, it took a while, but I got one. And the Green Lantern's like, I have a movie, but we don't talk about it. So, yeah, it's much like that type of humor, but it was cool.
Well,
it was fun.
I feel like they kind of had to lean on that in order for this movie to work, because, I don't know, that cartoon...
Mm-hmm.
I think what irritates you and other people about that cartoon so much is that it can be a show without the Teen Titans. Like why put them in these weird situations? And
it's
because like,
they have the
IP. So silly.
And it's unfortunate. Like Young Justice, I think it suffered from the fact that when it was... I don't want to say its original format, but like, yeah, in the early 2000s, Teen Titans, not Teen Titans Go, just didn't sell enough merch. And that's the thing. They canceled it, and then they brought it back in this new format, which is much more like the other cartoons that you'll find on Cartoon Network.
It's just very strange, because I know it has a big following with, like, kids and stuff, and it's like...
Which makes sense. I mean, it's something you can plop your kid in front of and not really worry about.
I know, but what happens when you actually, like, introduce them to, you know, I don't know, Young Justice or... You know, comic books, like, they're going to be so confused.
You kind of have to be a good parent.
That's so, like, that's so different than what fucking Teen Titans is.
Absolutely. And then what's even funnier is now they're doing the Titans show, which is
super fucking dark.
Super dark. And
F-bombs everywhere, my ears.
In the trailer, Robin's are like, fuck Batman. Which, if you haven't checked that out, check it out on the new DC Universe app. They're launching Titans, which is a live action sort of
TV show series.
Yeah, whatever. I'm losing the word that I already
live
about,
action it's a, series.
It's
drama.
Come back to it. I'll just spit it out at some point. But yes, it's going to be a live action version of the Teen Titans.
Why wasn't series good enough, bro?
I was just looking for a specific word. That's why. You know, you're all right, bro. You're all right. So you have a live action version of the Teen Titans. I didn't see Cyborg in the trailer, but I definitely saw Beast Boy, Raven, Robin. and Starfire, which, dude, and this is the sort of world that we're living in right now. Starfire got so much shit off of just a few seconds, like a few frames. The actress.
On Twitter and stuff?
That she literally quit social media. Because of, and the same thing that goes with like in Star Wars, the Asian actress that played Rose, she had to fucking quit because it's like there's so much toxic fandom out there. It's ridiculous.
So crazy.
And I'm so happy that we haven't fallen prey to that, except for that one comment that said that we suck dinosaur balls or something.
Not yet.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Yeah, but either way, it's like
you'll know we've made it when we finally get people.
I think that's what it is.
When we finally get people trying to kill us.
When you hate us enough to leave so many comments on every single thing, which we're fine with,
right?
Go for it.
And if they're all kill yourself, then
we've made it. I feel good.
We've made it.
But the thing is that not everyone's like us, where we have this fucking thick skin, and it's like so much hate goes out to just these people because they're like, you look horrible, blah blah blah. Like, dude, it was her choice.
If those were all my notifications on Twitter, I probably would kill myself.
Jesus. But so many people are leaving Twitter and Instagram and all that stuff.
I'm super sensitive. But also,
yeah, you are.
But also I'm very self-centered, so I need to know what everyone thinks about me.
Do I suck or do I not suck?
No, I don't know.
You're good, bro. Leave it, let it be.
I don't know how I'd handle it, like, honestly. If you had that many people, like...
I don't know.
I'd like to think I would end up, like, on the path that I've taken, or on the path that I'm on. Mm-hmm. I'd like to think I'd end up getting more of like my own type of people as fans,
yeah,
to kind of fight for me on the internet.
Oh, so definitely, and that's one thing.
I don't think it would be
as much as there's a toxic fandom out there. There is still a great good amount of fandom, and so
hardcore fans.
Like every time I click on something that I know is going to be somewhat controversial, you'll see the comment section where one of the top comments is some idiot like, yeah, this is bullshit. You're all bullshit. This is stupid. The Earth is flat. And then literally all the responses are like, are you fucking dumb?
Yeah.
Are you retard? Yeah. Like all this other stuff, like people like defending you, but the thing is, they get upvoted because when somebody causes this sort of chaos, that's the thing that takes the spotlight.
Right, and sometimes people just do it on purpose.
Like there's 1,000 comments that say this is awesome, keep doing it, and one comment where it's like this is stupid, and everyone responds to it, and because of the algorithm, it gets jumped to the top.
That's the one that's on top,
and that's why I say like. I don't generally click on comments unless I'm truly interested in reading not the top ones, but literally what people are saying.
Yeah.
But I will see, and there's always that same thing. It's like,
hey, we got some decent comments on our YouTube videos.
Oh, definitely. Absolutely.
On our movie reviews.
Yeah, stuff. Which is really cool. And like I love stuff like that where it's actually engaging. Like, you know, you guys watching right now, we love your comments in the comment section, you know, talking about stuff. Sorry, we can't really reply because, I mean, it's just us two. We don't have a moderator.
Yeah, we need... third dude.
Yeah, like a third dude or chick, whatever. Like a moderator that can actually go into and talk while we are verbally talking. But you know, we love everything you guys are saying in the comments. Thank you so much. Let's go on to what's opening this weekend as I refresh the page. Boom. So, you like poo?
When it comes out of my butt.
Okay, well, you like a bear that likes to eat punny? Eat honey named Pooh?
When it comes out of my butt.
All right, fair enough. All right, well, this bear may or may not be coming out of Ryan's asshole, but we have new Christopher Robin movie. It's a Disney movie based off of course, the Winnie the Pooh franchise, starring Ewan McGregor, Hayley Atwell, and a bunch of different voices for, you guessed it, Winnie the Pooh and his gang. Eeyore, Tigger, Piglet, Pooh. And Obi-Wan Kenobi as an elderly Christopher Robin. I've heard references to Hook, where it's essentially an older version of your main character just trying to be brought back to his childhood. And I don't think it's going to be as magical as Hook, because I love Hook, which is, I know, not the popular opinion.
You know what's funny is, like, before you got here, when I was sitting here waiting for you, I literally just watched, like, the honest trailer of Hook.
Oh, did you?
And it kind of tore it apart for me. And I was like, that's true. It's a super fucking depressing movie.
Yeah, but it's still fun.
Yeah, it's...
Take it at face value as opposed to digging into it.
But it's a generational thing. Most fucking people
You and I are on the cusp.
Yeah.
We were 1990, and so, like, everything that came out was pretty good. Like, and both of us are pretty... You know, like, open-minded, like, I think that all the stuff that people in the 80s liked, we liked. A little bit of the stuff that people in the early 2000s liked, we liked.
Yeah, for sure.
Everything now is fucking dumb.
Well, there was a. We talked about this before. Was that there was a buffer between things? Yeah. So like things lasted like a generation back then. Like yeah. Before the internet, you know. Like now,
yeah.
It's like
now everything just there's a new thing.
Out a new game system, a new fucking months, movie, yeah. This or whatever. It was like movies took years sometimes to get to your home video, and yeah. It was a big fucking deal. And then you watched that movie for like 5 years.
You know, like you popped it in. You're like, yeah. Did you ever call? Do you ever have one of those car rewinders?
I did. Only well,
yeah.
My grandpa
so
did.
So yeah. So my grandma did too. So I would just watch the video, go into a room, pop in the fucking video, rewind plop down it. The hood, rewind it, and just fucking wait for like 10 minutes. Like, yep. Pop it back in the thing. Okay, let's watch it again. Yep. And then you fast forward through all the previews. I don't want to watch this bullshit.
That was one of those gadgets that would always break on my watch, and everybody thought it was my fucking fault. Like, I wasn't using it correctly or something. I'm just like, you just put the movie in
there's
there.
Not really,
pop,
there's not much for to me it. To fuck up. It's
no,
just that.
I always got blamed for breaking VCRs and breaking shit like that, or like a tape would get tangled up or something. Like, what'd you do?
Yeah.
I just wanted to play the fucking movie.
I hear you.
Anyway, I wanted to talk to you. How did you ever watch Winnie the Pooh younger? I mean, what are your thoughts on this?
I never really watched Winnie the Pooh, but I played Kingdom Hearts, which is one of my favorite video game franchises, and there is a lot of Winnie the Pooh stuff that I didn't know about. And I was like, this is nice. It's a very wholesome sort of like entertainment.
Yeah.
But no, like growing up, I never watched any of the things. I know there was like a lot of VOD, like straight to VHS sort of movies.
Yeah.
And I think I may have watched one or two, but I never really cared about it. And I still don't, to be honest. But I understand the franchise. I understand how it works. And it's very, very much, like I said, wholesome.
Yeah. I'm like low key, like super excited for this movie.
Really? All right. Well, good.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to take that away from you.
Like, I really want to see it.
If you like it, definitely fucking, dude.
Vicky's giving me she's been making fun of me so much. She's just like, it's a boring, stupid fucking bear. Why do you like this?
Silly bear. Silly old bear.
She's like, it was so boring as children and stuff.
Yeah, but you don't get it, babe. He's like super chill and he eats honey and he's fat. So he gets stuck in holes.
And I know I'm going to fucking cry probably, too, because I'm a little
bitch. I know they're going to... It's Disney. They're going to stick something in there. Can you grab me a guava?
Yeah.
They're going to stick something in there where it's like... I don't know. Maybe Pooh gets ripped apart or something. And you're like, no!
Which has happened in the cartoon.
Yeah, I know.
Did you ever see that screen grab? It was like, no bothers were given that day. And his whole stuffing is
oh,
out.
Oh, really? No, I don't think I've seen that one.
Super funny. But.
Oh, bother. All right. Let's see. Move on real quick. The Velveteen Rabbit was sad as shit, according to the comment section. Jeremy Northwood said the Velveteen. Have you ever watched the Velveteen Rabbit?
I don't remember.
I heard of it. I don't remember it either. Okay. So you also have The Darkest Mind coming out, which is very interesting. It's
hold on. We're still on Pooh.
Okay.
I think it's great that they have all the original voices as well. That's like super awesome.
Do they?
Yes.
I feel like they're
maybe
different.
Not Eeyore. But
I feel like some of them have had to die.
Well,
I'm
it's
just
the
saying.
Same guy.
I haven't looked that
it's
up.
The same guy that's done like five different voices. So he does Piglet, Pooh, and Tigger.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same guy that does Darkwing Duck. And
isn't the same dude to do Optimus Prime? Isn't that guy?
No, I don't think it's that guy. Is it?
I think he does something.
He does Darkwing Eeyore. Duck. And
I have to look that up. But yeah, I mean, regardless... I really like that. I mean, I remember when the first Transformers movie came out, and I was super happy because they got the dude who was Optimus.
Sam Witwicky.
Yeah, it was pretty dope. That first.
You have to shove the old spark into my dick. I'm in trust.
I gotta piss. I'll be right back.
Ryan G. Piss out.
All right. And then coming up, too, we also have a movie called The Darkest Mind. Minds. This is interesting. It's going to be what looks like a young adult sort of X-Men. It is really just imprisoned by adults world. Wait, sorry. Imprisoned by an adult world that now fears everyone under 18. Weird. A group of teens form a resistance group to fight back and reclaim control of their future. Weird synopsis because it doesn't mention the fact that all these kids have mutant abilities. Like, literally, you watch the trailer, people are flipping fucking cars, breaking gates, setting shit on fire, moving things with their minds. So, I don't know exactly. I think it might have been based off a book, but it looks like these kids under 18 all have these powers that, of course, the adults have either suppressed or gotten rid of. And, of course, they're scared. So this looks interesting, but very much a young adult sort of thing. So I haven't seen anything that really intrigues me. I'm, of course, a fan of a lot of comic book movies and, to be honest, some young adult stuff. But this is like, I don't know, nothing really jumped out as far as unique as far as this goes. But, I mean, give it a chance if you're looking for a new franchise, because it looks like that's what they're trying to start it up. Next, you have The Spy Who Dumped Me. And this is going to be Mila Kunis with your friend. What the fuck is her name? God damn it. I hate when it doesn't say it right here. But you have Justin Theroux, you have Mila Kunis, and the weird blonde chick. Who's the weird blonde chick from Saturday Night Live? McKinnon.
No, is it
Yes, it is. Because I read it. You have Kate McKinnon and Mila Kunis, who play two friends who apparently Mila Kunis dated. Justin Theroux, who plays a spy.
Yeah.
And then has to... And she gets dumped and has to avoid other spies because they think she's a spy. And the whole thing goes weird because it's like a fish out of water. It's like, what's going on? I'm in the spy world now. And Kate McKinnon's like, it's okay, I'm weird.
Yeah. It looks all right.
It looks fine.
I mean...
It looks like another Bad Moms type of humor.
God damn, dude. I'm really sorry. My fucking...
What happened?
Bowels are...
Did you shit your pants?
No.
Do we have to order you new pants?
I just laid a mean fart in the restroom, and then I came over here, and I feel like I have to fart again, but I'm scared.
God damn it. All right. It's okay.
I'm gonna...
All right. Well, let's move it along then. All right. So this week, a new trailer for the
Nike.
Venom movie. Not Nike.
Oh.
That's an ad. A new trailer for the Venom movie has dropped, and it is polarizing, to say the least. I've heard a lot of people saying one thing, a lot of people saying another thing. I went and I tried to make as much of my own opinion as I could.
What do you think?
I really enjoyed the trailer. I thought the animation was a little bit iffy, but it is... What do you expect? This is actually my point with Green Lantern, in all honesty. So, going completely accurate... like comic book accurate, Green Lantern's suit is made up of from the ring. Like, it's not a physical suit. It's made up of light. So it makes sense that his suit would be CGI.
Right.
Venom is an entirely alien, symbiotic, liquidish almost suit.
Kind of constantly moving.
Constantly moving, exactly. So it would make sense that that's CGI.
So people are complaining
that it looks not great, but it's also accurate. In my opinion, so I'm on the fence. I have to see more about the movie, but the trailer looks okay. The suit looks okay. The voice is a little weird. Venom's voice, it's very much someone trying to imitate Batman. He's like, oh, we are doing this stuff. I have a dark voice. Roll out, Sam Witwicky. That type of shit. And but, I mean, it doesn't look bad, in all honesty. It just looks okay. What do you think?
This is the best trailer I've seen so far.
It's like, this is the best shit I've ever seen in my life.
No, honestly...
I'm going to open this guava now.
I'll go for it. Tell me what you think about that, too. Honestly, this made me pretty excited.
Okay.
Because, I don't know. I mean, I don't really mind the CG. I mean, mostly because, like... What the fuck does anybody have it to? I mean, to have to compare it to, like, Spider-Man 3? Like, okay, but this is like it's a suit from space. Like, how the fuck do you know what it's gonna look like?
It's an alien.
So,
and it's not like a xenomorph type of alien. It's an alien that literally is a symbiotic or symbiote.
So they actually said it right in this trailer.
Yeah, symbiote.
Symbiote.
Symbiotic relationship, and it's.
Yeah.
It's static, or not static, it's dynamic, so it's always moving, as opposed to, like, being, people were comparing it to Spawn, and I'm like, it's different. Like, Spawn, you can get away with it, because you just get a suit, and it's just like, boom.
Yeah,
And it's practical effects, and that's cool.
So in that screen grab that you have,
yeah, that
kind
of
has,
one.
There's like an extra head with teeth kind of
hanging
out. Yeah,
and that's the thing, is that
that looks
a great example of exactly what Venom is. It's not... a dude covered in a suit. It's an alien's like parasite, essentially.
That is
completely taking over your body, that can move in different directions, tear things apart, put them back together. It's not just a suit.
Yeah, I feel like people complaining, they don't understand.
They don't understand, true. But at the same time, it's like, it's a movie for the masses. Still, so if you don't like it, you don't like it. Still, it's an opinion. Regardless if you know nothing about this. So, I mean, that's what I'm trying to come from it from a sort of bipartisan sort of thing. I'm like, I'm looking at it. It looks interesting. I still reserve judgment. Nothing is saying that it looks horrible. Nothing's really setting me off as far as it looks amazing. What?
I wore my Venom shirt, bro. It's actually the band, though.
Good job. No,
whatever. Anyway.
I have a Venom shirt, and I'm going to wear it to the premiere for sure. Not the premiere, but like the one I just
Yeah. Anyway, I thought it was awesome.
Unless we get premiere tickets.
I thought it was awesome. It looks dope. I'm gonna watch it either way. I feel like people's complaints are just fucking internet complaints for the sake of.
I like this better. This is nice.
Yeah.
This is smooth. Okay, so this is also smooth. Sorry to interrupt, but this is the first time that I've tried this guava IPA from Pacific Plate. And in all honesty, like, I mean, you know that I'm honest. If they sent, like, they're sponsoring this, but if they sent us something and I didn't like it, I would say, there's some bad things about it. But in all honesty, like, this is good. I thought the guava would overpower it because any of you that have actually had a guava fruit in your house for more than a day, it makes the entire house smell like fucking guava.
Yeah.
And so I thought I would just get fucked in the face, but no, that's very smooth, very light, very very minimal amount, but enough to make it taste good. Yeah. And as followers of the show, you should know that I don't really care for straight IPAs because they tend to be overly bitter. This is very held back.
It's got a good
coming
finish.
At 6.5, which is nice.
It's got a good finish.
Yeah, I truly do enjoy this a lot. So if you see these, here, I'll show it to the camera one time. If you're interested in what I just said, definitely check them out because, I mean, like I said, I would not recommend something I don't like.
They come in 4 packs. That one, the guava, the balanced breakfast, the horchata stout, which is interesting. I mean, it's not for everybody, but if you like stouts. And
I don't remember the horchata one as much, but these two I enjoy. I will say I like the guava better.
It's kind of hit or miss, in my opinion. Sometimes the batches are a little bit, some batches are better than others.
Fucking batches.
But, what the fuck else was I saying? And the mango IPA is also.
I want to try the mango for sure. Because
it's pretty
the
much
only
the same
mango beer that I know of is the mango cart, which I don't really care for.
Yeah, it's not like that.
It's too light.
It's not like that at all.
Have you had the melon, the watermelon cart, or what, a melon cart? It's more new.
From Golden Road?
Yeah, it's a mango cart, but no. With melon.
No, I had the watermelon Dorado from Ballast Point, and that shit is.
It's way too overly bitter.
You can have like one.
Yeah, it's so weird. Well,
it's like a double, and then it's got syrup in it for like that flavor.
So I'm not a craft beer purist in the sense where it's like, oh, this brewery sold out and now it's different. If I notice an actual difference, then that's one thing. So Ballast Point, I've noticed an actual difference in quality.
Golden Road too.
And in Golden Road. So they're actually going the way that I think Ballast Point is. Whereas Ballast Point, once they got bought out, literally just started getting a bunch of different fruit versions of their Sculpin. And that's all I see.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I fucking see all the time.
Well, the Sculpin and the Dorado.
Grapefruit, habanero, mango, or whatever the fuck. Like different Sculpins in all of the liquor stores. And I'm like, I didn't even really care for Sculpin in the first place. And then I tried it. And I truly did try it.
Oh my God.
And it's like, it's more expensive and shittier tasting.
I'm burping up my lunch, too. And,
like you were saying, the watermelon Dorado. I've had it once, and I liked it. Then I got it again after they got bought out. And in all honesty, it tasted like shit.
Did it taste different to you? I don't know.
It did. To me, it did. Because the first time I had it was when we were filming It's Lurking.
First time, and I was able to actually kill a 6-pack of it.
Yeah, that was good. Then I bought it again for a party, and then I brought it. And literally everyone that tried it was like, it's weird.
Yeah,
it's and like I tried syrup. It. I'm like, this is so fucking fucked up.
Yeah.
Like, it's not the same. I don't care for mango cart. I've heard people interested in the watermelon cart or the melon cart, whatever. So, whatever. This, though, this is nice. I like this. Guava IPA from Pacific Plate.
Yeah. I like it a lot. It's
I like it. If you change it and I try it, and I'll tell you.
My two favorites.
I'm honest about it.
My two favorites from Pacific Plate are the guava and the mango. So if you could find them at any of your local craft beer spot in the LA area, definitely get yourself some.
Yeah.
Or just go to the brewery.
Yeah. Boom.
And any of the events we got going on, follow them on Twitter.
Bingo, bango.
And Instagram.
All right.
Anyway, hold up. There was something else I wanted to say about Venom.
Venom.
I don't know if we are
Venom.
I don't know if you knew this, but Woody Harrelson's supposed to be in it.
I don't know if I knew that either.
So Woody Harrelson is confirmed to have at least a small role in this movie.
I'm going to look it up.
So now people are speculating that he is going to be Clayton Cassidy, which is Carnage.
And I've also heard rumors that he is not Woody, but Carnage is in this movie, and you actually see him in the trailer. The girl in the red room, people are assuming it's Carnage.
It's not, though.
However, the Riot is no, but not the girl. Riot is the rich dude who's I fucking hate names right now, dude. I want to look it up right now. But yeah, so Riot is supposed to be the evil boss character.
Oh, okay.
And that's not what I was looking for.
2005? What the fuck is that?
That's not what I'm looking for.
Snake movie?
Mm-hmm.
Venom.
Why is this not coming up?
It's that one. Right there.
Okay, so you have Riz Ahmed, who is supposed to be Dr. Carlton Drake. Also, in the trailer, very obviously, you see him in combat with Venom as Riot. So this is Riz Ahmed.
Oh, I didn't notice that.
Yeah, this is Riz Ahmed.
Okay.
And that's
Tom
Hardy. And this is Venom versus Riot.
Okay, so you're saying that the guy that's like in that one room with the blades?
It's a female. There's a woman who is in a red room, and a lot of people are saying that that's probably Carnage. And you're definitely going to get more than one symbiote in this movie, but how many is unsure.
Total of maybe four.
But what did you say? Woody Harrelson.
Woody Harrelson, yeah.
Doesn't have a name.
Doesn't have a name, they're keeping it under wraps.
We shall see.
So a lot of people are saying.
But I love Carnage, and I cannot wait to see if something comes of that, from that, whatever.
Yeah.
Carnage is fucking crazy.
It looks
literally like it would take multiple symbiotes to take down Carnage, I feel like.
Yeah. Yes.
But I feel like also if he was in this in an actual predominant role, it would sort of overshadow everything unless he was the very end and you know that Venom's probably going to have to try and take him down later, cuz they're branding Venom as an anti-hero. He is not a superhero. And they're not branding him as a full-on villain.
Right.
They are very much branding him as an anti-hero, which is going to be a lot more morally gray. However, he's going to take down much more bigger bads, which you already see Riot, who's going to be what seems to be the big bad of this movie.
Right.
And I think it would do a disservice to both the movie and the character if they also stuck in Carnage.
Yes.
Carnage deserves a lot more. He should be the not even Loki, but like overarching more than one movie villain that literally is just the bane of all of these people's existence.
I mean, he is like, he's technically Venom's brother, the symbiote's brother.
Yeah, which is why
son or something.
Technically a son, yes.
Son, yeah.
If you go off of them, they regenerate son. or spawn asexually.
They just
bring off different symbiotes. Carnage did come from Venom asexually.
Yeah, and okay, one more thing before I forget that I wanted to mention was I do like the way he hit the scale of him was like it's super accurate to regular Venom,
and I appreciate that. Like, that's what I was saying.
The comic books is
literally all these
the
things,
big fucking shoulders.
They're trying to get it accurate,
and he's like 8 feet tall.
Yeah,
and yeah, it looked
and I'm like
awesome.
They're going for it, which is good. I'm just like the animation's kind of meh. And the weird
honestly don't
the
care about that.
Like, whatever, but we'll see how it comes
I like the
out.
Voice. I like the voice. I'm gonna
the
be
thing
honest.
Is, here's the thing. You can work on CG and animation until the fucking day it is released.
Yeah, yeah, until they got time.
Because there's plenty of movies that they showed you the first clip and people are like, this is weird.
Yeah, remember when Wolverine, like one of the
Wolverine
Origins
movie? The first Jurassic World, people were giving shit because all the dinosaurs looked shitty, and then they redid it and they kept working on it, and then it came out and it looked great and fine. No one complained, really.
When's the last time you watched Jurassic Park, by the way? Dude, watch that.
Last year for sure, but I don't remember when.
And fucking just like think about how that shit was like 20 years ago.
Yeah, dude.
It's even crazy. The CG.
We're not even talking about the practical effects, which are amazing.
Oh, well, those are amazing. I'm talking about the CG.
The first time you see a fucking dinosaur, you are literally, it's trying to put you in the place of Dr. Sadler. Yeah. She's like, fucking look. Yeah. Fucking look at the thing. And they're like, what? What?
Yeah.
Dinosaur.
Yeah. It's amazing. The CGI in that fucking movie. Just way ahead of anybody else.
And okay, so I know it's a rant. So many movies that are trying to get, like, bank on the nostalgia of older franchises are not understanding why things are important. And the fact that they're just kind of like,
true.
Hey, here's another movie with dinosaurs, or here's another movie with the thing that you like.
Yeah.
They're not capturing the magic. And this is not the story. But they're not trying, in my opinion. So we just got the first image of the new Terminator film that is literally supposed to take place after Terminator 2, because they're trying to kind of negate all the other Terminator movies that
Genesis was okay.
But overall, most people were complaining.
I thought it was pretty cool that they went back and forth. And
I like that they can bring it back and be like, hey, okay, well, let's try this one then. And the first picture looks horrible. It just looks... It's three chicks? It's three chicks. Not doing anything. Not telling you anything. Yeah. And they all look photoshopped. As opposed to, like, you know, fighting in a war fucking... seeing or anything cool of any magnitude.
It's a promo photo.
But that's the thing is people are picking these pictures as opposed to, like, there have been leaked photos on the set. And they looked, I was like, oh, that looks cool.
It's just like, why even put anything out?
Like, to sort of tease you. But the thing is, I don't know who the fuck is in charge.
One of the dudes on...
Like, hey, you guys are going to get excited about this.
Yeah.
And then we see it. I'm like, no, idiot. Do you even know why we liked this in the first place? First of all, the original Terminator.
So you're saying they didn't even show us a Terminator? So that's like that's what the problem is. But they showed us Sarah Connor.
What they showed us didn't get anyone excited, and that's the thing is whoever picked out the fucking picture is just like,
it's a weird picture.
An idiot.
Yeah.
Like, in all honesty, I'm like, I could have taken a better picture of my goddamn fucking Galaxy S7. Like, literally, I'm like, all right, let's not Photoshop this. Actually, look badass. Like boom, as opposed to them. All photoshopped and nothing going on, nothing telling us about the story except for just here's three chicks.
But that's just the fucking era. I'm not defending the fact that you're right, that it doesn't get us excited about anything.
And it's not just the Terminator series,
but it's the studios like trying to like do some sort of promotion, you know what I mean? Like, because obviously we're talking about it, so it's like, oh,
but
they,
in a negative thing and yeah, like the old saying is,
yeah, but the
old saying is no,
the story is they
no press or all press is good press, but it's not.
But the story is they dropped a photo, right? Like, that's the story.
Yeah, but it's in a negative light, because if you literally dropped a photo and it was a good photo, I would be talking about it, like, it looks fucking cool, as true. Opposed to like, this is bullshit. Why can't you guys understand that
true.
Terminator franchise, just like the Alien franchise, in my opinion, are horror movies. They should be marketed as horror movies.
The first one was.
The second also could be a sci-fi horror movie. In my opinion, there are so many shots that are scary and suspenseful in the second
T2?
Terminator. T2. I'm talking about T2. Think about the hallway scene in T2 where Sarah Connor
sees him.
Yeah, she's running for her fucking life because she knows, she remembers that thing, that exact thing tried to kill her. And so she's running from essentially what is your Jason Voorhees, your Michael Myers, your Freddy, who is just going at a leisured place. And even though he doesn't look menacing because he's not, you know, his intentions are different.
Right.
She believes in her heart that
he's
is
gonna kill her.
She's about to die. And that is what I'm saying. It's a Terminator movie. And now they changed it into a sci-fi action movie, which is whatever, but you're not even making us interested in it.
Well, that's how Aliens is, too. It's like a sci-fi action
and,
movie.
And that was my gripe with the new Predator trailer, too, because I was like, oh, cool, you have a new Predator.
Oh, yeah.
No one
yeah.
looks scared.
Yeah.
None of this looks like a horror movie.
Yeah.
This is an action film. An action.
So was the first Predator. Wasn't it? Didn't it? Didn't it? Does not
it
ring
didn't,
as
it
a,
didn't
as
rely
a
as a no. But I believe that it benefited from.
I mean, the first time
usage. I believe of horror film technique, which is
sure.
which is the whole thing of like you're not supposed to understand the villain. You're
sure.
not supposed to know this, and sure. and giving like showing us glimpses is one thing, but just like here, look, it's a badass hybrid.
I can't believe
alien,
they blew their full load
predator.
With the giant predator
right?
in that
I'm
predator
like,
trailer.
Okay, I guess we got a giant Predator trailer.
That's fucking...
He's a Predator on steroids.
Yeah.
Which, in all
that,
honesty...
Isn't that like the
like,
big surprise? It's supposed to be like a big reveal. They gave
yeah.
it to us in the trailer.
And, I mean, I'm this is no comment on the movie. Obviously, I've never seen it, but...
What?
Even the... No, on any of these movies.
Oh.
Like, I'm just saying about marketing. Whoever's in charge of these marketing things is failing, in my opinion. And I think that these people like what was it? AVP actually did a great one, because I didn't know what the alien predator looked like until I saw the movie.
Really?
There might have been.
Never watched Predator before.
What?
With an alien predator? What do you mean?
AVP.
Yeah, Alien versus Predator, right?
They had a hybrid alien predator.
Oh, I don't remember that.
Oh my, AVP. Sorry, Requiem. AVP Requiem, where they had an actual
so the sequel to AVP,
and I'm not
see,
saying
that's
it's
a
good.
Super deep cut. I don't even know how the fuck that you even saw that.
Yeah, I'm not saying that that's a good movie because I saw it and I was like, ooh. But either way,
sounds awful.
They I think they did it right as far as what they were trying to market, where it's like you know there's an alien predator hybrid, but you don't see it until way late in the game, and then you do see it and you're like, oh fuck. Exactly.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's just my own gripe with it. Like, I have such a passion for movies that I don't understand why marketing teams don't understand that magic, literally, like how we use it, is an entirely big part of advertising a movie. And
I,
so if
I can answer that, it's because most marketing dudes who get these like big fuck, it's just because they have a fancy degree and they're not actually the people. They're just
yeah.
some dudes who got like a crazy degree and they're like,
this looks cool. Throw this together,
yeah.
make an explosion, boom, boom, boom,
they don't
boom.
Fucking understand that, you know, what the fans want.
And it's even not even just big ones. Like I remember,
they don't deserve to be in the movie industry. Period. I mean, like anybody who's
I don't know why anyone hires any of these fucking people.
I mean, it's a long time. Horror story of like,
and in my opinion, this really bodes well for people who are fresh out of school. If you have some skill, go for it, because there are so many people out there that don't. If you can really get in front of the right eyes, in all honesty, you're gonna get a job. You have to work
yeah.
for it, no doubt. No doubt you have to work for it, but if you have some skill, show it off.
It helps to be Jewish, by the way.
Okay. Okay. All right, moving on.
I'm just saying.
Ryan D., moving on. real quick, I want to mention, dude, the whole thing with MoviePass is fucking ridiculous.
Dude, the whole thing?
Yeah. Well, MoviePass has literally climbed, like, this giant roller coaster that started off, and it was like, oh, this is neat, and then it dropped off.
It was a
and
cool
then
idea.
And then it jumped, then it's like, hey, you get unlimited movies for $10. It jumped up, and then it's like, we don't really have that much money, and we're gonna get all these rules and blah blah blah. Then we're gonna do some shady shit, and it just fucking plummeted.
Yeah.
Now they are removing so many showings of different films from different theaters, to the point where constantly people are screenshotting and sending in to different media. Like, you know, there's no more screenings for this movie theater. There's none of these. Nothing's working. To the point where they've literally announced, no, we're not going to let you see new movies anymore. Because,
oh, jeez. How much were you paying a month for MoviePass?
$10. That's not my gripe. That is not my gripe whatsoever. The gripe is that, and I've been a MoviePass customer, is that they had no idea what the fuck they were doing. And
yeah.
were constantly changing things and not being transparent. and completely changing things on the fly to the fact where I would try and watch a movie, and it's like, nope, just you can't. Yeah. I'm already at the theater.
Yeah.
Nope, you can't.
Well, that's also because remember you said that there was like a deal that AMC wanted to make with them early on, and they basically told them to fuck themselves.
But that's the thing, like that had nothing to do with the fact that they couldn't use it. Because of the fact that they're going through...
you don't think so? You don't think that they...
No, they're going... Because I understand what the business platform is and how it works. They're going through a credit card company, I believe is MasterCard. I have to double check.
Right, but
they're giving money to the thing. So they can't deny... AMC can't deny it because AMC is getting the money. They're just pissed off at MoviePass for what they're trying to do.
Right.
But they can't just deny... AMC never denied anything. MoviePass was the one that did every single thing as far as not letting their customers see movies, as far as not telling them about stuff, as far as changing policies.
I see. So they were already
literally, literally no one, even though they were angry, publicly angry, like yeah. AMC was the biggest one.
Yeah.
They never denied entry to MoviePass holders. Oh. MoviePass was the one that did this, and to the point where so many people left, the stock for MoviePass just plummeted. I myself, this past week, just canceled my membership. Also, because AMC just released AMC Stubs A-List, which is 1,000 times better. And I'm surrounded by like 3 or 4 different AMCs.
Yeah, the one you got right here is fucking bullshit, though.
Yeah, but it's a different market. But either way, that's down the street. I have Montebello right there, Puente Hills.
This one, Santa Anita, never has any of the box office hit, like the big box office ones.
But either way, that's
never
fine.
Do.
That's fine. I don't care.
I guess.
I mean, I like
that bugs the fuck out of me because this is the closest one to me too.
Is it?
Yeah.
Not Montebello?
Yeah, Montebello, but Montebello is kind of small, so it gets packed. No. Oh, and this one doesn't even have.
But with AMC A-List CD. Stubs, you can order your tickets online ahead of time.
Yeah.
And that's one thing that I was so pissed about with AMC or with MoviePass.
Oh, you couldn't do that?
No, you have to wait 1 hour before the movie. Yeah, then you have to physically be on the premises to buy your tickets. And then I would get there like, it's sold out. I'm like, fucking.
Yeah, fuck all that. That's a deal breaker for me.
Absolutely. MoviePass just did such a poor job of taking care of its customers.
Stubbs A-List just buried that whole business completely. Like
not just that, because there's also other people or other companies that came out with their own thing. But yeah, AMC is definitely the largest movie theater chain.
They're renovating all their locations. They're fucking constantly like making a better movie experience.
And I don't care the fact that it is AMC A-List or Stubbs A-List is I believe $20
$20 a month,
$19.95 a month today,
and you get 3 movies a week.
And you get IMAX, you get Dolby, you get Real D, 3D, digital, all that stuff. And you can order ahead of time online.
Yeah, and reserve
not have
seats.
To fucking stand there and be like, oh, maybe I will or maybe I won't get my tickets.
And you automatically become a Premier Stubbs member, which gives you rewards for every movie you go see.
Exactly.
Which is like, that's kind of a big deal. Dude, every movie.
AMC has no affiliation with this tiny podcast. No. We are literally saying the fact that like I've been a MoviePass customer, and I was pissed the fuck off. So much that literally they're like, why are you, like they give you the option. It's not a requirement, but the option to like, why are you leaving? I'm like, you guys fucking suck. I'm going to AMC Stubs. Dude, and like literally like all
it's
this
the best deal.
There's I literally have times where I would constantly open my app and it just wouldn't work.
The MoviePass app?
Certain things. It was one of those things where it's like, no, we're just not gonna let it happen. Like all different features would work in the app, yeah. And then I would click on one thing, crash.
All right, I'm getting drunk. We should move on.
All right, cool.
Except, wait, one more time. Did I tell you about my? Because I'm a Stubbs Premier member already.
Okay.
And they just announced this A-List thing, which I plan on joining, but I'm already a Premier Stubbs member.
Uh-huh.
And I love it. I fucking love it because I get those rewards, and I fucking I get to jump line and all this shit. So like, there's 2 different lines at every spot in AMC. So
yeah.
Like, there's the Premier members line, so every concession stand, I think even the bar has a fucking Premier members line.
Oh, does it? Yeah.
So I get in the Premier members line, and I saw this dude throw the biggest tantrum for them calling
I think
me.
You told me, but I don't know if it was on
for calling me ahead of him. He was like, "You already called like 6 people. I've been standing here." I was like, "Stubbs, bro.
That's the point.
Get the fucking.
It's literally the point.
Get VIP."
And no, I would get pissed too, but I mean, I have to understand. I'm like, that's the point.
I get his.
It's literally the draw.
Yeah.
It's like, pay us more money and we will treat you better.
Yeah, I paid my dues, man.
True that.
It's $15 for the year to get a Premier Stubbs Premier.
And yeah, and it's something that at least we use all the time.
I use it all the time.
I would say, I mean, this is me paying full price. I would go to a movie at least once to twice a month. With AMC, Stubbs, A-List, I would go at least 3 to 4 times a month, for sure.
Yeah, me too.
Maybe more. I would see a lot more indie films.
There's a movie theater.
Because of the fact that I'm right here, and these are these more indie films, I would check those out because it's so close.
Yeah.
I'm like, day off, like, I have this pass. I'm like, I'll check out this fucking random film.
There's an AMC across the street from my work.
Boom. Boom. And in Dolby, and in IMAX, whatever the fuck you want. All
right, what's next?
Fuck 4DX, because I like my spine.
I'm getting...
Last story for me, we got Marc Maron on the cusp of being cast in the new Joaquin Phoenix Joker movie. So, I don't know if we actually reported on this, because, I mean, we're not in the business of reporting news as it breaks.
Oh, we're not?
No.
Oh.
We're two guys that like to get drunk, and hopefully, and from what we know, you guys like hearing us talk drunk.
Yeah.
But
oh yeah,
yeah. There is a new Joker movie that has no ties to the current DC universe, as if you were thinking like a Marvel universe.
Yeah, we've definitely.
This is a standalone film that has Joaquin Phoenix as the Joker, and then Robert De Niro has officially been cast, and they are now looking for Marc Maron, who is a great comedian and a really nice podcast host.
He's a good actor.
He's you may have noted him from Glow, from Netflix series Glow, and they are trying to get him on there. And I think this cast is going to be great. If you have ever watched any DC animated movies, you understand kind of how this works. They have a sort of storyline, and then they can just kind of throw one out there that has nothing to do with any of it, but you understand it.
Yeah.
This is a Joker film, but it's just not that Joker. You know what I mean? So it's like, right now, in the DC, in the animated universe, they have a sort of storyline that goes on.
You have high hopes for this?
I do. This is one of my most anticipated movies in the entire
year.
Really? In all honesty, because of the fact that it has no restraints. Because of the fact that this is not Jared Leto, this is not Ben Affleck, this is not anything that has anything to do with anything before, except for the fact that it's comic book based.
I just hope they don't do
anything. There is nothing holding it back.
I hope they don't do anything stupid and like reveal some shit that like...
That's marketing. That's something that we just talked about.
They gave us such high hopes about fucking Jared Leto being the Joker in Suicide Squad, and like he ended up being super... a big flop in that fucking...
I have a different opinion about that. Like, I actually enjoy him. I think that they just didn't use him right.
That's a whole other conversation.
What I'm saying is the fact that because of the fact that they have no restraints and how good they are with their animated movies, if they treat this like the animated movies, I think that this could be amazing.
Could be. I never.
It's a standalone Joker movie. I guaranteed you're not going to get an origin for the Joker. A definitive one. Sorry,
I don't think so.
I don't think you're going to get a definitive. Like I like how Christopher Nolan and Heath Ledger.
Some people are saying we're going to get the Killing Joke origin, which is like the fucking prologue of.
That's a thing, but the way that the Joker works, you don't necessarily know that that's even real. He could have made all of that up.
I guess.
Like I said, it's all about storytelling, how you tell a story. So if they make it seem, if they even go that direction, if they make it seem like he's just making it up, cool. I don't care. The thing is, if they treat it the right way, which I know that they can.
How do you know they're going to go that route where he's telling the story? Like, what
I
if they just?
That's I don't know any
like,
of
what
this.
What if they just make the movie of him being a failed comedian?
I know that
and becoming the Red Hood or whatever.
I know that based off of this casting, and what I know that they could go with. I'm excited. I have no way of saying that this is going to be good or bad either way. But Robert De Niro, Joaquin Phoenix, who is known for only picking like stuff where he can really work his acting chops. He's no Paul Giamatti as a rhino. I'll tell you that. he's not going to just cash a fucking check because
that was a deep pull,
dude. Like, I'm just saying, like, Paul Giamatti, I respect as an actor, but I saw him as a rhino. I'm like, what the fuck?
Shitty Russian accent.
Yeah.
Shitty CGI.
Joaquin Phoenix is not going to sign on to this unless he truly believes in this. Marc Maron, I actually, I do respect him as an actor greatly.
Yeah, I think he's got a good ear on, his hand on the pulse for, like, all the good
and
things.
In all honesty, I think that DC has something to prove. It's
of course they do.
But no, that's the thing that Gabe's, they're hungry for it. And that they're figuring out, hey, everyone's saying that we are good with these animated movies.
Yeah.
And we have this on lock.
Yeah.
What if we just said, you know, fuck the Marvel route of having a DC universe.
And just coming up with all these different
spin-off
movies.
And just fucking make one good standalone movie.
That's what they should have done in the first place.
I agree. But I'm just saying, like, I think that they're figuring it out now.
Sure.
So, mark my words, I think that has potential. I have to wait till the footage.
I'm not as excited as you.
I have to wait for footage, but yeah, I understand. I understand there's a lot of trepidation. There's a lot that you can be.
I'm just always let down with these movies, bro. You haven't even watched fucking Justice League.
No, this is what I'm saying. I'm saying that I understand what they could do.
Yeah.
It's got potential. I'm looking at the signs.
We'll see.
Justice League, there was plenty of signs that said bad. Yeah. I'm saying that there are plenty of signs here that they're like, you know what? Fuck that. Fuck that route that we were trying to do. Yeah. They were trying to play catch up to Marvel, in my opinion.
For sure.
They can come
Let's
back.
Let's move on to
shit. I'm done.
I'm fucking drunk and I got a shit.
Go again? Did you shit already?
No, I didn't.
Okay. Well, how about you get your own segment? What?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Secrets of nature's deepest mystery.
She is literally like launching eggs out of her pussy. The poo-poo, eat the poo-poo guy. So they just like tie up these dudes and fart in their face. And then he cut off his dick. This
is gonna blow your fucking mind. You ready?
All right.
Oh, yeah. Juicy.
I'm fucking buzzed, man, so I hope I can pull this off. I'm just reading off my tiny phone here. You guys know who Alex Jones is, right? I had to explain.
Mike Jones.
I had to explain to you who Alex Jones was.
Mike Jones?
Come on, bear with me here. Cause
Mike Jones.
Okay.
I'm drunk, too, so.
Yeah. Okay. Alex Jones is the crazy fucking conspiracy theorist on InfoWars. And apparently he was on Spotify. I didn't even know that he had, like, podcast. Well, I'm on Spotify. Hit the mic so it's Spotify. Apparently Spotify has a strict policy on hate speech.
Oh, does it now?
So the streaming service has recently was recently blasted for providing the far-right conspiracy theorist with a platform. Many users expressed their objections on the Spotify community board, threatening to cancel their subscriptions if the streaming service of canceling their subscription if they continue to feature the Alex Jones show.
Okay.
So up to 1,700 people suggested to remove Alex Jones show.
Okay.
So this is from Spotify. We take reports of hate content seriously and review any podcaster episode or song that is flagged by our community. Spotify can confirm it has removed specific episodes of the Alex Jones Show podcast for violating our hate content policy.
Okay.
So this is one of the dudes that is like claiming that Sandy Hook was fake.
Yeah.
The shooting was fake. And
so here's the thing. I'm not great with names. Ryan definitely told me who this was, but as soon as I saw his picture, I knew exactly who he was.
Yeah, he's that crazy dude.
Yeah, like I said,
he's fucking crazy.
Like I don't pay attention to a lot of people's names
crazy
or these people.
But he feeds crazy shit to like other crazy Republicans.
Big bald guy that just goes ape shit.
Yeah, you know, you've seen him, dude.
You've most likely seen at least a few memes of him.
He's mostly famous for giving those families of the Sandy Hook massacre like real grief for fucking claiming that they're all actors and that their kids weren't actually murdered in that fucking shooting.
Yeah. Okay.
That's like his big thing, and like he's since because he's been served with a lawsuit. by one of the fathers.
Yeah.
He's since backed off on that and kind of like, oh, I could be wrong, whatever. But like, but because he actually has to go to court for it.
I would say he's the definition of a shock jock. Yes. He's just trying to get ratings by saying the most outlandish shit.
He says some crazy shit, bro.
Yeah, there's literally videos I see pop up on my feed where it's like 10 things that Alex Jones said that or predicted that didn't come true.
I love it, though. Because it's so crazy that people believe this shit. Like, it cracks me up.
It cracks me up, but also depresses me deeply.
Of course.
Deeply.
But especially, like, how fired up he got. Like, when
this is
when
why Hillary, I don't read the comment section of anything.
I know, but man, just to see that dude get so fired up about like
crazy shit. So they got rid of a show or what happened?
They only took down a few episodes, so I guess they're having somebody filter through some of the shit that he says, and they're kind of censoring him.
Okay, fair enough. Because I will actually say, and this might come as a surprise. I'm actually opposed to that. Granted, if you have a policy set in place, which it sounds like Spotify did, that's fine.
Yeah.
Then yeah, if you violate it, then get your shit taken down. However, regardless of whether I agree or disagree with anything you're saying, I don't think that your voice should be taken away. Maybe I might want to punch you in the face at some point. But I'm just saying.
Let's be honest. This is just
as far as your actual platform, you cannot censor someone from saying things.
This is
whether they have consequences is a completely different thing.
This is a tiny
understand.
This
that.
Is a tiny fucking damper on his following.
Oh yeah.
It's not a big deal.
Absolutely, but I'm just saying, like I mean, you and I are both. We try and keep this non-political as far as a podcast goes. But I think our listeners understand where we're coming from, the side of logic.
But it also could be, you know. But I get what you're saying, like by all the shit that we say,
somebody
who has a political
agenda
exact
opposite
could be
like, oh, take Humpcast down,
take them down
because they say things that I don't agree with,
right? Exactly,
and I disagree with that, obviously.
I'm with you.
But same thing goes with this guy, that he could be saying everything that we disagree with, and I would not tell you that he deserves to get his show taken away or his voice taken away.
I'm with you, but
if you fight him and destroy him or whatever the fuck, that's a very different story. However, but like actually taking his show away, I wouldn't agree with that.
Okay,
but if you have a rule set in place and you violate a rule, that's a different thing. It's literally breaking the rules of the game.
So I guess Spotify they're going through their policy and going through his show and considering what they consider hate speech.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, which
we go live on Facebook and we go through SoundCloud. If SoundCloud said you can't have, I mean, it's a ridiculous
thing. Can't talk
about
dicks anymore.
Yeah, you can't talk about dicks or you can't drink beer. Then obviously we're like, well, fuck SoundCloud. But I'm just saying, like, if we broke the rules,
they're tired of listening to us drink.
If we broke the rules, we would understand that our shit would get taken down.
Right, seriously.
And we appreciate that they would only go over episodes as opposed to the show.
I gotta wrap this up because I'm like gonna shit my pants. All right,
Ryan's gonna die. Through his ass.
All right. This is a cool story because there was a real life heist of the Swedish royal family's crown jewels. So the Swedish royal family is no doubt glamorous.
Are the crown jewels made of meatballs? And
I don't know what you're talking about.
IKEA.
And so is the crime that left it and their subjects. Short, two priceless historical crowns and a royal orb.
Orb?
On July 30th.
That's a ball. That's a testicle.
In broad daylight, two thieves jumped into a speedboat moored below the... I don't know the fuck to
Was
say
the
that.
Speedboat from IKEA?
Strängnäs Cathedral in southeastern Sweden.
Definitely from IKEA.
Definitely. And escaped...
The speedboat was made from car...
Will you just fuck... Okay, they escaped, dude. All right. They escaped. They fucking stole... The royal jewels just jumped onto a boat, stole the fucking things, and jumped onto a speedboat, took off, and they were in pursuit by fucking helicopters, boats, and cars, and no one caught them.
Good job, Sweden.
It's fucking crazy. That's awesome. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Ryan B. Nevers.
All right, well, Ryan's going to take a shit. I really do appreciate you guys watching and listening, however you are. I know this is a late episode, but we want to rather give you more quality content than just me putting out something too early or whatnot. And because of the scheduling, it's a little bit difficult. And I really want to say that I truly do appreciate. Of course, everyone in the comment section, we love you. Thank you so much for listening and watching however you are. Subscribe to us however you listen to us. Check out Humpcast on Twitter and Instagram and all that stuff. You can follow me personally at Garrett_AM Lee at Twitter and Instagram, and my daily happenings at Mitch_Striker. And we will see you all next week. Bye-bye.